Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Have you ever looked at a bottle of salad dressing before you shake it and noticed that the vinegar is always at the bottom and the oil is always at the top? Do you know what happens when you mix oil and water? The water separates to the bottom and the oil rises to the top. Both of these situations occur due to a difference in each liquid's density. Density is the ratio of an object's mass to its volume. In this lesson, we will be learning more about this important property of matter. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define and calculate density. Density is the ratio of an object's mass to its volume. But before we get into density, let's pause for a moment and define mass and volume. Mass is the amount of matter, or stuff, in an object, and is usually measured in grams or kilograms. Volume is the amount of space an object takes up. For liquids, we measure the volume in milliliters, or liters. For solids, the unit for volume is usually centimeters cubed. This unit comes from the formula of volume for a rectangular prism. To find the volume of the prism, you multiply the length times the width times the height. Let's look at an example. In this prism, the length is 70 centimeters, the width is 23 centimeters, and the height is 23 centimeters. To find the volume, you would multiply 70 times 23 times 23, and you would get a volume of 37,030. If you look closely at the units, you have centimeters times centimeters times centimeters. And if you think back to your math class, anything multiplied by itself three times is called cubed. So the units would be centimeters cubed. When calculating the volume of different three-dimensional shapes, it is important to use the appropriate formula. In this class, we will only be using the rectangular prism formula, but you will learn about the other formulas in your geometry class. The density of an object is the ratio of its mass to its volume. In other words, it is how tightly the particles are packed in an object. In this example, feathers have a much lower density than bricks, so it will take a much higher volume of feathers to have the same mass as the bricks. When discussing density, it is common to compare an object's density to the density of water. The density of water is equal to 1 gram per milliliter. This means that 1 milliliter of water has a mass of 1 gram. If you want to compare the density of an object to the density of water, you simply place it in a container of water to see if it sinks or floats. If an object floats, like the piece of cork in this image, it has a density less than water, or less than 1 gram per milliliter. If an object sinks, like the metal in this image, the object's density is greater than the density of water, or greater than 1 gram per milliliter. This same comparison method can be used to compare the density of liquids as well. When liquids separate into distinct layers, they separate with the highest density liquids at the bottom and the lowest density liquids at the top. What do you think that means about the density of oil compared to the density of water from the opening of this lesson? The oil has a lower density than water, meaning its density is less than 1 gram per milliliter. In fact, olive oil has a density of 0.9 grams per milliliter. The formula for density is density is equal to an object's mass divided by its volume. Usually, density is measured using grams for mass and milliliters or centimeters cubed for volume, which then gives density the unit grams per milliliter or grams per centimeter cubed. It's time to work through some sample problems. In this class, we are only going to solve for density, given a mass and a volume. However, in chemistry, you will sometimes be asked to solve for the mass if given density and volume, or solve for volume if given density and mass. Our first example asks, what is the density of an unknown liquid with a mass of 133 grams and a volume of 7 milliliters? Our first step is to ask yourself, what information do I have? Well, we have mass and volume. We also know that we are solving for density, so that is our unknown and can be labeled X. Let's write that down. Now, let's write our density formula. Check our units. Do we have grams for mass and milliliters or centimeters cubed for volume? Yes, we do. So we can now go ahead and solve. Let's plug our values into the density formula. X is equal to 133 grams divided by 7 milliliters. Finally, we use a calculator to solve the problem. We find that X equals 19 grams per milliliter, which means the density of our unknown liquid is 19 grams per milliliter. Okay, example 2. A block of wood has a mass of 180 grams and measures 10 centimeters long, 6 centimeters wide, and 4 centimeters high. What is the density of the wood? If you remember from our previous example, our first step to solving density problems is to write down what we know. We know the mass is 180 grams, so that goes with the M in our list, and our density is what we are solving for, so we put an X next to density. What about volume? Are we given the volume of the wood block? Well, not quite. We weren't given the volume, but we were given the dimensions of the wood block, which allows us to calculate the volume. Remember, the volume of a rectangular prism is equal to its length multiplied by its width multiplied by its height. So, in this case, the volume is equal to 10 centimeters times 6 centimeters times 4 centimeters. This equals 240 centimeters cubed. We can now add that to our list next to volume. Let's check our units. Are they grams for mass and centimeters cubed for the wood? Yep. Great. The last two steps are to plug the values into the formula and solve. The density of the wood is equal to 180 grams divided by 240 centimeters cubed. Using a calculator, we can find that density equals 0.75 grams per centimeters cubed. So, the density of the wood is equal to 0.75 grams per cubic centimeter. We're going to try one more example. After this, you will have more practice problems to try on your own in the lesson PDF. If you get stuck, you can always come back and re-watch this video to help you work through the steps of the practice problems. Our final example of this video asks, what would be the density of a liquid that has a mass of 196 milligrams and occupies a volume of 0.10 milliliters? Our first step is to write down what we know. We know the mass is 196 milligrams, so that goes with the M in our list. Our volume is 0.10 milliliters, so that goes with the V. And our density is what we are solving for. So we put an X next to density. Let's check our units. Are they grams for mass and milliliters for volume? Oh no, they aren't. Our mass is given in milligrams, not grams. This is where our unit conversions come in handy. Think back to our previous two lessons. What is the conversion factor for milligrams and grams? 1,000 milligrams is equal to 1 gram. Great! Using our conversion factor, we can take the mass of 196 milligrams and multiply it by 1 gram divided by 1,000 milligrams. Remember, you want to have the unit you are changing in the denominator and unit you need in the numerator. 196 times 1, then divided by 1,000, is equal to 0.196. So 196 milligrams is equal to 0.196 grams. Let's put that in our list for mass. Now that we have our list all set with the correct units, we can plug the values into the formula and solve. The density of the wood is equal to 0.196 grams divided by 0.10 milliliters. Using a calculator, we can find that density equals 1.96 grams per milliliter. So the density of the liquid is equal to 1.96 grams per milliliter. If we added this liquid to a container of water, would it form a layer above or below the water? It would form a layer below the water because its density is greater than the density of water. As we went through the lesson today, we defined density and discussed how it relates to an object's mass and volume. We also went over some practice problems during which we solved for density, given mass and volume. In the lesson PDF, you will continue to practice solving for density. Our next lesson is a review and assessment of what you have learned during our Intro to Chemistry unit. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. Hey, hey.